Subscribe Smartic Magic's channel and hit the bell icon beside it, and on the bell icon select all to watch latest tech videos before anyone else. Hello friends, myself Dushit Kumar Dash. Once again, welcome back to my YouTube channel Smart Tech Magics. Let's start with today's tech news, and this is the 16th episode of it, so let's begin. Starting with the first news is coming from Nokia. Nokia 9.2 will debut in the first half of 2020. The new development comes just weeks after rumors stating the existence of Nokia 9.2 as a successor of the Nokia 9 PureView. The Nokia 9.2, which is said to be powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon 865, won't be showcased at MWC 2020 in Barcelona next month, but is in the pipeline for the latter part of the first half of this year. The latest report mentions that unlike Nokia 9 PureView that packed the light camera technology, the Nokia 9.2 would come with a big sensor from an old camera partner, such as Toshiba. Nevertheless, the smartphone is said to offer a great camera experience. It is reported to have a price tag close to Nokia 8 to attract the masses. To recall, Nokia 9 PureView was launched in India at ₹49,999, and Nokia 8 on the other hand debuted in the country at ₹36,999. Alongside the Nokia 9.2, a separate report from NokiaMob.net has mentioned that HMD Global is in plan to bring its 4-level phone, and it's said to arrive either late 2020 or early 2021 with a clamshell design similar to Moto Razr, which was launched last year. The next news is coming from cybersecurity research regarding the bad side effects of e-vehicles. I mean the next generation smart e-vehicles. Researchers warns that as governments, including in India, plan more e-bikes on roads to help tackle traffic congestion like any internet-connected device, hackers can cause series of attacks in e-scooters, including spy on users and even spoof GPS systems to direct riders to wrong locations. Researchers from University of Texas at San Antonio said that vendors of micromobility vehicles can also suffer DOS attacks and data leaks. Some e-scooters models communicate with the rider's smartphone over Bluetooth low energy channels. Someone with malicious intent could spy on these wireless channels and listen to data exchanges between scooter and rider's smartphone app by means of easily and cheaply accessible hardware and software tools such as Ubertooth and Wireshark. The next news is coming from Poco. Poco X2 is set to launch in India on February 4. The brand separately sent media invites for the launch event taking place in New Delhi. Additionally, Flipkart has revealed through a teaser that it will be carrying the smartphone in the country. The new Poco phone, which is speculated as a rebranded version of Redmi K30 4G model, is teased to have a display with higher than traditional 60Hz refresh rate. A recent Geekbench listing suggested some of the key specs of the Poco. The listing hinted that the phone would run on Android 10.
Poco India hasn't yet confirmed whether it's bringing the Redmi K30 4G variant as Poco X2 or not, but the image showcasing at the bottom of the Poco phone featured on Poco India site does suggest that it could have same design as Redmi K30 4G that also has the identical looking bottom area with three vents for loudspeaker grill, pinhole microphone, USB Type-C port and a 3.5mm headphone jack. The next news is coming from Apple. According to the latest rumor, we might see Apple release iOS 14 for the same set of devices that support iOS 13 last year. Though there is a possibility that the company might drop the support for iPhone SE and iPhone 6s. Apple is expected to unveil iOS 14 at the company's annual WWDC in June later this year, as it has done in the past. List of devices that are expected to support iOS 14 are iPhone 11 series, iPhone 10 series, iPhone 8 series, iPhone 7 series, iPhone 6s series and iPhone SE. Now, obviously 2020 iPhone models will directly ship with iOS 14 on board, and with that it is good to see Apple adding support for devices that are 5 to 6 years old. However, as I already said earlier that it is possible that company could might drop the support of iOS 14 for iPhone SE and iPhone 6s depends on the next several months of software development. The next news is coming from Google Pay. Google Pay on Monday added a new UPI feature that will let them to link FastTag accounts to the Google Pay app and recharge and track their payments. According to the company, to recharge their FastTag accounts, users need to open the Google Pay app, look for the FastTag category under the bill payment section, and then select the bank that has issued their FastTag. On the next screen, users have to enter their vehicle number and proceed to pay with their bank account. Users can also check their FastTag account balance for FastTags issued by supported banks clients with a tap of a button. If you don't know what is FASTag, then let me say you that FASTag is an electronic toll collection system operated by National Highway Authority of India. It employs radio frequency identification technology for making toll payments directly from the prepaid or savings account linked to it or directly toll owner.
So today's tech news ends here. If you like this tech news, then please hit the like button. Like target is only 50. Please help me to complete my target. And if you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe it and tap the bell icon beside it. And on the bell icon, select all to watch my latest videos before anyone else. So once again, thanks for watching. See you soon in my next video. Until then, goodbye.